Hello, I am Aurélien Antoine, and this presentation is part of the IRCAM Forum Montréal 2021 event. I will discuss harnessing the computational modeling of the perception of orchestral effect for computer-aided orchestration tool. This talk will be divided in four parts. First, I will introduce the perceptual effect of orchestration. Then I will detail our development for creating computational model of this effect, which will be followed by discussion about the potential outcome for computer-aided orchestration tools. I will end this talk with some concluding remarks and ideas for future work. Let's start with talking about the perceptual effect of orchestration. First, what is musical orchestration? It can be defined as writing music for an orchestra, which doesn't say much in that definition. Orchestration is also defined as the art of combining instruments, which is still a bit reductive. A better one is from McAdams, defining orchestration as the choice, combination, and juxtaposition of instruments to create a specific musical effect. That's what interests us here, the use of instruments to create specific musical effects, and orchestration has many of them. I'm going to talk a bit more about orchestration effect and start with showing you three examples. The first one is an emergent blend in Schubert Symphony 8, first movement, where the clarinets, bassoons, and horns blend together, which is shown in the red box on the score. The second example is a punctuation blend in the fourth movement of Berlioz's Symphony Fantastique, where we have all instruments playing together at the start of measure 17, which is also shown in the red box on the score here. The last example is the contrast effect in Mozart Don Giovanni, where there is a call, shown in purple on the score, and a response, shown in green. The alternation of the two groups of instruments and the repetition of the notes pattern played by each group create a contrast. These orchestral effects, such as blend, segregation, and contrast, are experienced by listeners as a result of several auditory processes. Research on the topic has suggested that many sonic and musical characteristics contribute to shaping these effects. Kuchel and McAdams define three categories for orchestral effects following three auditory grouping processes. Blends are the result of concurrent grouping, where there is a perceptual fusion and event formation. Sequential grouping makes connection of events into continuous streams, which lead to segregation or integration. And finally, segmental grouping, where there is chunking of event streams into perceptual units, which lead to contrast or progressive orchestration. So, how do we create a computational model of orchestral effect? Well, research has suggested that several cues contribute to the perception of these effects. There are sonic and musical characteristics. It relies on auditory scene analysis principles, and these effects are perceived and experienced by listeners. And here I want to emphasize on listeners, meaning the perception is due to listening to audio or sound. And we can see that all of these characteristics are related to sound and auditory processes. So we can ask, is it all in the sound? Or maybe these effects are already present in the musical score and resulting from composer's choice. We wanted to evaluate the extent to which the symbolic information written in musical score provides sufficient data to model the perception of the orchestral effect mentioned previously. For our developments, we work with orchestral pieces from the late 18th to early 20th century, with composers such as Berlioz, Brahms, Debussy, Mozart, and Schubert, among others. And we acknowledge that this is only a small part of the vast orchestral repertoire. We work with computers, so we need musical scores that can be read and processed by them. For that aspect, we use scores encoded in music XML and created by our partner, OrpleMusic. And we have individual computational models for each orchestral effect. Now, due to time constraints, we'll only detail our work for one orchestral effect. Other effects can be discussed during the roundtable event. So I will discuss our development about modeling orchestral blend, which is a sonic fusion between two or more instruments. In regards to auditory scene principles, sounds that have similar evolution are more likely to be grouped together following gestalt principles. Research has suggested that onset synchrony, harmonicity, parallelism in pitch and dynamics, spatial position of instruments, and room acoustics, and also musician performance, are cues contributing to orchestral blend. However, information about some of these characteristics are not present in symbolic information. So we base our blend estimation on information related to onset synchrony, pitch harmonicity, and parallelism in pitch and dynamics. And we perform these calculations and decisions measure by measure. Here I'm showing you a synopsis of our orchestral blend estimation algorithm. As said before, we do estimation measure by measure. The first step is to retrieve the information of the active instrument for a given measure. Then we look if there are instruments playing in synchrony. For that, we compare the onset of every note, and depending on the decision threshold, we keep groups of instruments that play in synchrony. If we use this example from the first movement of Debussy La Mer, if we compare the notes of the English horn and the cello, we can see that they are all playing in synchrony, and here they will get a score of 100% due to all notes having the same onset. The second step is to look if there is harmonicity in the group of synchronous instruments. This is performed in two ways. First, for each onset, using intervals, the algorithm looks if the notes are in a harmonic series, using the lowest note as the root, and this works similarly to applying a harmonic template. If this is negative, the algorithm evaluates if there is an harmonic structure formed by the note played, following traditional Western tonal chord rules. For example, in this blend from the fourth movement of Berlioz, Symphony Fantastique, the notes are spread across several octaves and don't form an harmonic series. However, here we have a G minor chord with notes G, B flat, and D played by different instruments. Here we have a root, a minor third, and a perfect fifth. Finally, we look at the evolution in pitch and dynamics. Using the blend example from Debussy again, we compare each note for each instrument and evaluate if it goes higher, lower, or stays the same. If we look at the note played by the English horn in measure 122, we can see the second note is lower and the third is lower as well. It is the same for the cello playing lower and then lower again. We do a similar evaluation for dynamic changes. Once these tests are done, their scores are average, and if it is above a defined threshold, the group of instruments is output as a potential blend. Note that a decision threshold set at 100 means that everything has to be perfect, so every note has to be played in perfect synchrony by every instrument. It needs to have a perfect harmonicity and perfect parallelism in pitch and dynamics. Lowering the threshold allows for greater flexibility from these rules. Okay, so you may ask, does it work? Well, we were wondering the same, so we chose to compare the model output with human expert annotation. For that evaluation, we use data from the Orchestration Analysis and Research Database. This database contains several annotations of perceptual effects of orchestration made by musical experts who had access to scores and professional recordings of the orchestral pieces. Here we have an entry of orchestral blend in Mozart Don Giovanni, where we have information about where the effect is happening and the instrument involved, for instance. If you want more information about this Orchard database, I invite you to look into the talk titled The Orchestration Analysis and Research Database by Stephen McAdams and colleagues, which is also part of the IRCAM Forum Montreal event. Going back to our model evaluation, our ground truth corpus consisted of 32 orchestral excerpts and represented 229 blend labeled by human experts and involved 1,032 measures in total. We also wanted to see if all the cues have to be perfect to create a blend or if there are some flexibility. So we used two other decision thresholds for our performance evaluation. Here, the table shows the number of blends detected by the computer models compared to the 229 identified by human experts. We can see that when we set the decision threshold at 100, meaning everything has to perfectly follow the ASA principles, the models have detected only 178 blends out of 229. And 220 and 221 for the other decision threshold, meaning around 96% of the blend have been detected in this case. I could end my talk here and tell you it works well and detects almost every blend, but we need to look a little bit closer. And we need to see if actually all the instruments involved in a blend are retrieved. To do that, we compare the instrument identified by human expert with the one from the model. If we use this blend example from Mozart Don Giovanni, the human expert have identified oboe 1 and 2 and clarinet 1 and 2 as creating a blend effect from measure 62 to 66. The model has output the same four instruments for each instrument for each measure. So we got 4 out of 4, which gives us a ratio score of 1. We did the same comparison for all the 32 orchestral excerpts, and using again the two different decision thresholds. We also consider the label example in two ways. First, we consider a blend as one event, regardless its duration. So we had 229 label examples. The second approach aims to address the difference in duration across the blend. So we consider each measure having a blend as one blend. So here we had 1,032 label examples. From the results shown in the table, we can see that a model strictly following the ASA principles, only 48% of the instruments involving blends were actually retrieved. With some flexibility, the performance is increased significantly, with around 80% of instruments successfully retrieved with the other two thresholds in both approaches. While lowering the decision threshold increases the performances, it also groups extra instruments that were not identified as part of the blend by the expert. Here we have the phenomenon of false positive. In the case of the threshold set at 60, we have almost 14% of extra instruments on average across all excerpts. The challenge here is to find the right degree of flexibility from the rules and minimize the false positive. Because of course, if we set the decision threshold at 0, we will get a 100% success rate, but it will be full of extra instruments, not part of the effect. So we saw that we can detect blend effect from the symbolic information with estimation based on onset synchrony, pitch harmonicity, and parallelism in pitch and dynamics. We also saw that it is not strictly bounded to ASA principles. And with around 80% of success rate, we may ask, where are the remaining 20%? Well, it may be information related to timbre, and I cannot do a presentation about perceptual effect of orchestration without mentioning timbre. Some estimation based on processing audio sources could improve the models. There is also musical context, which is more difficult to evaluate and estimate. And of course, there is information related to individual perception. Let's talk now about the potential outcome of developing these models for computer-aided orchestration tools. Well, orchestration is also the study of writing music for an orchestra. So with computer capable of detecting these effects, we could perform automatic orchestration analysis, which would take only a few seconds or a minute for longer pieces. I'm not saying replacing human analysis. It will actually provide them material for people who want to analyze specific pieces, composer style, or repertoire. This could also aid in understanding the mechanism of orchestration. If we understand why and how specific effects are created, we can teach about them in orchestration classes, for example. In regards to computer-aided orchestration tools for composition or automatic generation, these models could be used as target for the CH algorithm for best instrument combination, or also used to assess the output of the composition or generation tool and see if they match the user choices. Again, if we understand the mechanisms for creating these orchestration effects, we could incorporate this knowledge into the combinatorial rules of these tools and aid in shaping the ideas of the users. clock is ticking, so I will finish this talk with a few remarks. So we saw that instrument combination creates specific effects, which are perceived as a result of two different auditory grouping processes. We also saw that we can create computational model of perceptual effect of orchestration using the SA principles, and these effects can be detected from processing symbolic information. In the case of the work on orchestral blend detailed in this talk, the model has been able to retrieve about 80% of the instrument involved on blend on average. In order to improve the accuracy of the model, it will be necessary to incorporate timbre properties extracted from audio signal processing. We also aim to increase the analysis corpus, both in number of pieces and repertoire. Finally, we talk about the potential outcome for this development for tools designed for orchestration analysis or instrument combination. These outcomes could be discussed further during the roundtable on timbre and orchestration at the IRCAM Forum Montreal event. That's it, and thank you for watching this presentation.